Let's talk about San Martin. Super excited to make this video today, guys. Off the bat, I want to let you know that this is not a sponsored review. I did pay for the watch. It doesn't have to get sent back, and I'm not receiving any compensation to make this video. It was just the right time for me to add a San Martin into my collection because they just released the SN0118-G, and it is of original design. Now, in this review, I don't want to talk about their finishing. I don't want to talk about things that are already covered. What I'd rather talk about is more up-to-date things about San Martin, and I'm going to touch a little bit on the past with them. So, with this watch, it's something that really spoke volumes to me because I didn't have a summertime watch in my collection yet, and it absolutely screams summertime vibes with the colorway. And I want to speak about San Martin being a watch company that's only considered to be homage, and it's really not, because if you look at the history of San Martin from when they began, they only had original designs to start with, and it wasn't received very well. Some of their designs were a little bit out there, and probably the community or watch collectors were not ready for such a thing, but it seems like they're going back to their roots because they just opened up a brand new company called Jin Wan. And that company is going to be an independent brand focusing only on original designs. And that is in line with this watch because it is an actual original design, or so they claim. Comment down below if this watch is a homage of another watch that you know of. I'm hoping that it's not, because the whole premise of me obtaining this and putting it into my collection was that it claimed to be an original design, and I really hope it was. That factoring with the summertime vibes, it was just the right time, and that's pretty much how I'm collecting moving forward. I'm not just shooting off at the hip. I am aware of the companies that I want to add to my collection moving forward, and there's reasons behind it that have nothing to do with the watches. I'm really looking at brand names now and seeing what they're doing, how they're contributing to the community, and everything else before I even look at any of their watches. So I may already know that I'm going to add a watch in the future into my collection from a company, but I'm going to be waiting for a particular watch that they create that really speaks volumes to me and really connects to my collection. So without further ado, guys, let's get into the review. So guys, before we unbox this San Martin, let's take a look at this mystery box that I have here. It is a Seagull, and I'm going to be comparing it to the Seagull that I got from AliExpress. So let's do a quick wristwatch check, and I'm wearing my Seagull 1963 that I got from AliExpress, and I'm going to compare it to the watch that we have in the box here. I have it on my Zero Pass strap to see that nice movement. So that's a video to come before we look at the San Martin. But let's, of course, unbox this handsome watch. This was the box that it came with, the white box, and it is covering this green case here that's a single watch holder, and it came with a tool for the bracelet, and it's very nice, very, you know, strong piece of metal here. So if you have to size the bracelet and unleak the screws that they have as pins in that, that's not going to be an issue at all. I got tons of screws, but it's nice that they include that. And I have the paperwork in the background against the box tools that I have for you guys to see, because we don't want to see the paperwork. We want to see the watch, right? So let's open this up. I really do like this package that they have here for the watch. And here we go, guys. Here is the summertime vibe watch that I got, the SN0118-G. Nice little pillowcase that we have here. And let's run through the specs. So again, SN0118-G, NH35, 316L stainless steel, 40 millimeters by 47.5 lug to lug, thickness of 12.4, 20 millimeters lug to lug. It has a screw down crown that's 6 millimeters in diameter, sapphire crystal with AR coating, and it has a bezel that has 120 clicks unidirectional rotation. Sandblasted process for the case finishing. And I know we mentioned that we weren't going to talk too much about the finishing, but come on, we have to include that here. I mean, it's just so well done, man. Brush all over here on the case. You saw the crown there being signed. There's even a nice finishing between the lugs here, and it looks absolutely phenomenal. It's well done. I went with the solid case back, like I said earlier, because I wanted to just have a little bit more insurance on the water resistance. There was no need for me to really go with the see-through case back. It is, in fact, an NH35, so it's nothing too spectacular to brag about when it comes to that. So let's put this on the time grapher to see how she's running altogether. So plus or minus 3 or 4 seconds of day, 298, 297 on the amplitude. The beat error is 0.1 and 21,600 beats per minute. It's running and performing better than a standard range for an NH35. So pretty happy with that. And let's throw her on the scale. Just the watch alone, we've got 70 grams on the watch just by itself. And with the mesh bracelet, we're coming in at 126 grams. So that's the weight of the measurements that I got for the combination that I got together. So let's talk about this dial. Let's break it down. So the colorway that I chose was the orange, and it has the teal on the chapter ring, blue on the bezel. And again, that's more of a matte blue, but let's really get up on that dial because man, oh man, when you do, it really speaks volumes as far as it being a summertime vibe, because that dial is going to look like an orange skin, I think. And I think oranges really remind us of summer for some reason, but it looks very nice. It has that lighter color on the middle coming out to the end, getting to a darker kind of feel to it. The applied indices are well finished, as you can see. Everything is loomed to perfection. There's barely any, you know, mistakes that you could see on the hands, on the applied logo, on the applied indices. The date wheel is a big thing, right? Because they decided to match the date wheel with the color scheme of the dial, and I give them a lot of pluses for doing that. That's one of my pet peeves. I really like for it to be looking more integrated. And I want to give them a big shout out for not putting a Cyclops at that date wheel. I personally don't prefer it. I mean, that's more of a preference thing, but I was much happier with the watch not having a Cyclops on there. But guys, we're right up on this dial. We're magnified to an extreme amount. And you could even see at the text at the 6 o'clock that the finishing is absolutely spectacular. You could see a little bit how it's raised up before they applied the text on there with the paint. And everything is pretty crystal clear, very sharp. And there's just no, you know, fuzziness happening at any of the corners or anything else. So very well done. Let's look at the applied logo at the San Martin here. And as you can see, it's pretty heftily lifted off of that dial, very well engraved. And even the numbers on the chapter ring, well lined up, well applied, very visible, very clear as day. You see how crisp that is. You could even see on the bezel, the markers on there, they're pretty well applied, pretty straight, pretty clear as crystal. You know, you're just getting a finely done product. It's just well detailed, well finished. There's no back play on the bezel, and it lines up really, really well at the 12 o'clock. So no issues with that kind of alignment, which I know is aggravating for a lot of people. So I was really happy that I got something that lined up pretty well. I hope all of, you know, the models that they produce, you know, follow suit with that. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much a wrap. I think they did a phenomenal job when it comes to the details. Let's take a look at the bracelet. 19 millimeters at the end here. It tapers down a little bit down to about 17.7, and then 20 millimeters, 21 millimeters at the clasp itself. Again, with the pins, they're going to be screwed in pins, so pretty easy adjustment. Just take that little tool that they included there to make that adjustment. And then taking a look at quick release here, quick release at the ends, so very nice. Two ends there to push in to just take that bracelet off, 1, 2, 3, not a problem. The clasp was very, very nice. It clicks in very well. It has a quick release here. It came in handy for myself already, coming in and out when my wrist swells, and it's very easily adjusted. You just push that little notch in to pull it out, and then to secure it, you're just pushing it in, which it clicks and secures into place. Now, I haven't had any issues with it securing too tight on its own, so not a big issue there, like having to push that in to secure it tighter. So a very nice function for the quick release. Everything is milled. They have the logo here, which is embossed and in a hexagon shape, so it's very nicely applied. Now, the only touch that they have where they have a actual chamfered edge is on this bracelet, more so on the buckle, as you can see from the sides here. The rest of the watch is just a nice brushed edge. Now we did a time lapse here to see when that date wheel is going to turn over, and it is at +5, which is totally acceptable for me. That's pretty fine. -5, +5. The loom looks great. It does last primarily through the night. It is pretty bright and visible, nicely applied, as I said before, as you guys can see. And the AR coating holds up very strong. Here I am on the Brooklyn Bridge. Very bright and sunny day. You could still see the dial with no issues. So the AR coating was applied very handsomely. So guys, I really don't have any complaints for this watch, to be quite honest with you. It seems like San Martin is looking to improve and listening to enthusiasts as a whole, giving us the quick release on the bracelet and a quick adjust on the clasp. Matching that date wheel is an absolute plus. Now, the only thing that I would say, it's more of a personal preference, to be honest with you, is I would have liked to have seen that date wheel at the 6 o'clock instead, and I don't really need the text, but you know, again, that's really just a personal preference. Overall, they've done an excellent job with the quality of this watch. And if you're looking to get a summertime vibe watch, I definitely recommend any one of the three colorways that this watch comes in, because you can count on getting the quality as far as all of the specifics and as far as all of the details. So let me know what you guys think of the watch. I appreciate you guys for tuning in and checking out this review. If you haven't seen my last review on the Vinicenico Aventurina glass, check that out if you have a couple more minutes. And remember guys, it all started with the watch. No matter where you are in your journey, no matter how you decide to collect, you guys are all welcome on this channel and viewed upon as equals. So I'll see you guys real soon, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one. San Martin, known more mainly it's crispy. Oh.